reason to be jolly. La 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 la, la la la.
Oh, Lee, what a busy time of year. I can't even get my cooking done. It's so cold. I wonder why those curlers would want to be out in this kind of weather. Well, I think I'll bring some of my Christmas cards that I just got out of the mailbox. Oh, this one is from my friend Dan. Dear Beth, just wanted to drop you a line. Sorry I haven't written sooner. It's been so hectic the past few months. Jill was diagnosed with ALS a couple years ago. Symptoms are worse and nothing seems to help. The doctor says he doesn't have much more time, so this Christmas could be his last year on earth. God has blessed us for so many years and we are trusting him to help us through these hard times. Just don't know how people make it without the Lord. Hope your family is well. Celebrate the time God gives you with your family. Missing you. Love, Jan. Oh, makes me sad. The very last Christmas of the year. You think this could be my last Christmas and I don't even know? I think I'll go mail some of my cards and take a nap.
Could it be, do we ever stop to think, what if this were our last Christmas? Let's take a look now at Beth's dream.
Gotta get my phone. This is not a very pleasant job. It's very tiresome to deal with these people every day who are so reluctant to be passengers. Yes, Lord, I know it's a job of great right of responsibility. I have just a few more passengers together for this flight. I'll finish it up right away. Sandy Wright. Sandy Wright.
What do you want with me now? You must be calling for my grandfather. I mean, he's old. He's almost 90. His mind wanders, and he doesn't even recognize the family most of the time.
Well, I'm sorry, Sandy, but you're the one who has been scheduled on this for the departure on this flight 12/15/19.
Listen, I don't want to argue with you. Just let me talk to your superior, and I'm sure we can straighten this whole thing out.
Oh, no, it's too late now for you to establish force contact with him. You had over 40 years to do that.
But I'm an average American woman. The pamphlet from my insurance company said an average American man could expect to live about 70 years. That means I should have at least 10 more years to go.
Come on, Sandy. You've got to leave on this flight.
Oh, no.
You got another line. In the rear compartment, please. That's a seat that your name is on. Barbara Calhoun. Barbara.
Oh, me. Did you call my name?
Yes.
I'm not ready. There's so many things I've got to do, I can't leave now. And it's Christmas, you know.
Well, when you're scheduled for this flight, you have to come. There is no cancellations allowed.
Why didn't you give me at least an advance notice? Why didn't you warn me? Even a few days' time would have helped, given me a chance to get things organized. I'm so busy right now.
Well, you should have known that any day you might have been scheduled for your departure. You've seen others go unexpectedly. Why didn't it occur to you that you'd have your turn too?
Well, for one, I would have appreciated a chance to get myself prepared. I never got around to making out a will, and poor Charlie, he don't know where the insurance policy is. I kept it in the desk drawer with all the old paid bills. Wow, he'll go through all that junk. I should have gotten rid of that stuff a long time ago. I just hate the thought of anybody going through my things. I wished I'd cleaned that dresser drawer out and the closets too. Oh, why couldn't you just come after spring cleaning? Then I could have been more prepared.
That's not what I meant by being prepared. All you need on this trip is a robe of righteousness. Please take your seat. Martha Dawson.
Don't rush me. Where can I put my lunch?
Oh, I'm very sorry, but you don't need to bring anything at all on this trip.
Oh, no, but I hate to leave things behind. I spent a whole lifetime gathering all these lovely things. I was so busy gathering them that I hardly had time to use them. If I can't bring them along, do you suppose I could have another 10 years on Earth? Can I make a reservation for the future? John will soon retire and we can have some fun together. We can relax a little. It would give us a good chance to enjoy our new home and the new things we have worked so hard for.
No, Martha Dawson. Your time on Earth is used up.
It just isn't fair. All my beautiful things I'm saving for a special time. It makes me sick to think about it. All the pretty things I received as gifts and put away. I've always wanted to save those things for something special for the future.
The future Mrs. Dawson will appreciate that you've took such good care of your things.
The future Mrs. Dawson? Do you mean to tell me that John has already found somebody new and got her all picked out?
No, but he'll probably find somebody.
I hope she doesn't use my grandmother's good china. I never used it myself. It was always kept nice and shining in the china cabinet just for show. I hated to see it be used because one of the children might break some of it.
Now, they'll be glad that you kept it in such good condition. Finally, in death, you'll share your belongings. Too bad you can't see people enjoying them. Please have a seat and fasten your seatbelt. Bill Evans. Bill Evans.
Oh. Thank you for getting me reservations. I thought you'd never find room for me. You know I'd ask over and over again to have you come. I've suffered so long. There was no purpose for my being alive.
Yes, there was, Bill Evans. The death angel cannot come unless God says your useful time on earth has been completed.
Sometimes I was tempted to take matters into my own hands and just come and get on a flight without waiting for you to call. What good was I? Sick in bed, old and crippled. I was just a nuisance to everybody. They were all anxious to have me go. I don't blame them, though. They were run ragged. I don't see how I could have been useful in such a condition.
The Lord knows so much more than you ever know. He loves you, and he loves your family, too. Now, you'll really appreciate going to a place where there is no more pain, no more crying. You'll be with Jesus, and all the past is forgotten.
I've always known that God loves me, and I've loved him dearly for it. But still, it was awful hard to be patient all these years.
Well, someday your family and friends will appreciate what you've taught them, the way you prayed and trusted in Jesus, the concern you had for them even when life was a burden for you. Your long illness was so hard on them, but someday they too will know God has blessed your soul.
Thank you for your comfort. I know they'll miss me for a while, but I'm sure they'll be relieved.
Go over and take your seat. Melinda Franklin. You must come now because you're scheduled to go on this flight too.
Oh, please, please, not this time. My children still need me. If you could just give me 10 or 15 years, it wouldn't be so hard on them. They'd be out of school and big enough to get along. How can God take me now when my family needs me? There's so much I have to do, and I've gotten so behind this Christmas.
No, Melinda, your work is done. You know God loves you and your children.
But they'll miss me. So many people will miss me. They depend on me.
God is doing only what is best for you and for them. You have your robe of righteousness. Come, fortunately, you won't be sad. Your sorrow and troubles are all over. You will see your Heavenly Father today, and immediately you will be assured that whatever His will is best. You'll see Him face to face, and all will be clear, and was once very puzzling and confusing. Take your seat, please.
Wait, wait, Angel. There's a friend of mine on this flight, and I didn't expect she'd leave so soon, or I would have offered her this robe of righteousness. Can I just talk to her for a few minutes?
It's too late now for that. Why didn't you do that all these years that you've known her?
I've known the good news that Jesus died, that we could live forever with Him, but somehow I was just too shy to talk to her about it. I was always too busy. There just never seemed to be a good opportunity, and I meant well, but I just kept putting it off. Now you've called her name, I just have to give her this.
Sorry, madam. This flight is ready to depart. Passengers have all been gathered. None can return for
but
any reason.
It's all my fault that she doesn't have this robe. I know she can't go to heaven without Jesus in her heart. I feel so bad.
You have the message of hope for the world. It's very foolish for you to get too busy and too shy to share it with others. You have a job to do. Start in your home, your neighborhood. Go tell those who still have time. The first stop is hell. All passengers without a white robe of righteousness are requested to leave by the rear door.
But I'm not ready.
I don't want to go.
Me either. This is
what terrible. About what about this robe?
I'm sorry, Sandy, that's not enough. A saving faith in Jesus Christ is what you need. Only that can cover all your imperfections and make you fit for heaven.
Now you tell me.
Well, it's just not fair. Why didn't somebody tell me? I had a friend that went to church. She never told me anything.
I didn't kill
I'm
anybody.
Not ready to go. I'm not ready to go.
Try to go back.
Terrible.
Try to go back.
But I don't want to go. I don't want to go.
Either it's terrible.
She's awful.
But the one thing is missing, and they was not ready to meet the Lord. This is the final stop, is heaven for these. And listen, you can already hear the music. You're going to be in the wedding feast. See how bright it's getting? See that light?
The timeless theme, earth and heaven, will pass away. It's not a dream, 'cause God will make all things new. That day gone is the curse from which I stumbled and fell, and evil is banished to eternal hell, and there will be no more. all around. Now the nations bow down to see, and the only sound is the praises to Christ our King. Slowly the names from the book are read. I know the King, so there's no need, there's no need to dread.
I can't this Christmas in a worldly one, but does it really matter? I left him out, almost as if he were a nuisance. That's not what's important. It's Jesus that's important. Celebrate Jesus. Oh Lord, come make time for everyone and everything. I want you to help me change. Help me put you first, love you most, and serve you best. I want my children, my family, and those around me to see Jesus in me. Thanks for a wonderful gift, Jan. I'll never forget that. Merry Christmas, Jesus.
In the time that you gave me, did I give all I could give? Did I love all I could love? Did I live all I could live? Was my faith in your grace strong enough to save me? Did I do all I could do in the time that you gave me? In the time that you gave me, did I face the devil down? Did I make him turn away every time I stood my ground? If today is the day you should decide to take me, did I do all I could do in the time that you gave me? Oh, and I'll never know till it's over, but I wanna fly on your shoulders. I might have strayed from the path, I might have gone a little crazy. I'd like to think I did you proud in the time that you gave me. Fly on your shoulders. I might have strayed from the path, I might have gone a little crazy. I'd like to think I did you proud in the time that you gave me. And as the hourglass empties, no, it won't even face me. If I did all I could do in the time that you gave me.
Will you join us now as we share together a family worship to share the beautiful story of our Savior's birth?
Now, it's time of year that many any of us say Jesus lives back more than any other time during the year. And if you're not ready, then you need to be thinking about it. And the rest of the program, we're going to talk to you about Jesus and how he was born, how he did his disciples. And we pray that you will have keep that in mind and celebrate with us.
Isaiah 9:15. For unto you this day a child is born, and unto you a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Okay, the Prince of Peace. Well, the angel of the Lord said to Joseph, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived is of her is of the Holy Ghost. And thou shalt bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people.
And it came to pass on those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. Luke 2:1. It was a decree, an order from the emperor. It was the law. And Joseph obeyed the law and went with Mary to his ancestral home of Bethlehem. Could it be that there was no place for them to stay? No grandparent, no relative, no friend, no room at the inn. Would a king be born in a stable? Yes, this was God's plan.
I should mention this. The day we had to switch a lot of parts because of sickness. And I don't want you to miss a song that's beautiful. So Mike, if you would play Mary Wrapped a Present to the World, and you'll stand, we'll sing it.
Falling down that night, with no place to rest in sight, soon she would bring forth a son. The inn was full, so instead, he was born in a stable bed, and there his life had just begun. She supposed to know, as she wrapped him in swaddling clothes, that her perfect newborn baby boy would become a sacrifice. He would run and he would laugh and play, but his manhood would bring the day when for the world he would choose to die. Mary wrapped a present to the world on that first Christmas morn when her baby was born. Mary wrapped a present to the world. There were no lighted Christmas trees, just one bright star so all could see the way to Bethlehem that winter's night. Many gifts they brought to him, but a greater gift she gave to them, for through her son would come eternal life.
Mary wrapped a present to the world.
Yeah. angel of the Lord appeared to awaken the country shepherds in the field and said, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." They must have been afraid, but they listened and they followed. They told others about Jesus. They returned glorifying and praising God. What an example they set for us.
This is a song of commitment. Listen to the words.
Born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. They rejoiced, they worshiped. The story gets more beautiful with age. And that's why we keep telling it, to remind ourselves of God's great gift to the world. And the story does not end in Bethlehem. He came to seek and save that which is lost, to take away the sins of the world. That's you and that's me. Our friends, our families, even the strangers we meet on the street. Through him we wipe away all sins. When our time on this earth shall pass, we shall live with him eternally. Today, let us all commit ourselves to serve him and to put him first.
Christmas time was approaching, snow was starting to fall, shoppers choosing their presents, people filling the mall, children waiting for Santa, with excitement and glee. Little boy tucked my sweater, looked up and asked me, Where's the line to see Jesus? Is he here at the store? Christmas time is his birthday, why don't we see him more? At this message profound, I looked down to thank him. He was nowhere around. The little boy at the mall might as well have had wings. As the tears filled my eyes, I thought I heard him sing, Where's the line to see Jesus? Is he here at the store? If Christmas time is his birthday, why don't we see him more? Where's the line to see Jesus? He was born for me. Santa Claus brought me presents, but Christ gave his life for me. In the blink of an eye, at the sound of his trump, we'll all stand in line at his throne. Every knee shall bow down, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Where's the line to see Jesus? Is he here at the store? If Christmas time is his birthday, why don't we see him more? Where's the line to see Jesus? He was born for me. Santa Claus brought me presents, but Christ gave his life for me. Where's the line? Where's the line? Where's the line?
Thank you. running out the door looking for Jesus. Our last song is a song of praise as we picture when Jesus returns to the earth. Just imagine how amazing this is. You know, he comes and he gets the dead in Christ first. And then those of us that are living, we're going to go and meet him in the sky. Amen. And it's just a glorious thought to think about that. And this morning, I hope you'll open your heart and listen to the words of this last song. It's an old song titled The Midnight Cry.
Mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet as Gabriel sounds the call. Prophecies fulfilling, and the signs of the times, they're appearing everywhere. I can almost hear the Father as he says, "Son, go get your children." Midnight cry, the bride of Christ will rise. When Jesus steps out on a cloud to call his children, the dead in Christ shall
While everybody is bowed, no one's looking around for just a moment. You know, I took from this place the importance of being prepared. If you're not prepared this morning, we're not asked for a song of the chat, but if you're not prepared, prepared in just a moment, if you'd like to come and receive Jesus Christ, or if you feel that you've neglected your duties you have for the Lord, I'd like to pray you come at this time. Father in heaven, as we come to the close of this wonderful program, and appreciate so much, so many who worked so hard, even in the midst of the last hour, several getting sick that could not come today. We pray for them. Lord, we thank you for Sister Judy. I know she worked hard to put all this together. All those that was in the play that participated, we're grateful for them. We're grateful for our church and our church family. You've been mighty good to us. And as we all begin to sort of pause and take note of just a short period of time now, we'll be the time that we celebrate the birth of Christ. And I pray that each of our services would do that and honor Christ with our life. We're going to be receiving the love offering in just a moment. We ask you to bless the giver, as well as those who maybe do not have the give. And when it's all put together, it'll be beneficial and helpful. Bless our church, our missionaries, and all those whom we try to help along the way. We love you this morning in Christ's name. Amen. You know, I really appreciated Sister Judy's song y'all sang. But that song y'all sang, "Where He Leads, I'll Follow." You know, in the middle of March in 1967, I was commissioned to become I was already preaching gospel, but they do that. They gather around and lay hands, and I received my certificate and all those things and all. And I thought, you know, that's the song that they sang. The choir had a nice choir, and they sang that song. And I thought, all these years, we've tried to follow the Lord. He's been a great help to us. We have so many states, and so many revival meetings. And every minute, second, day, week, or year, I've never regretted, because the Lord, you know, has honored that song with my life. Where He leads, I'll follow. I think of so many of you that are here this morning. I've never met you before. I come from over 600 miles away by way of several churches to get here, but I'm very grateful and appreciative. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for every gift, for expression of love, every hug, every handshake, all that you've done to help us in our ministry along the way. It's been one of the easiest churches I believe I've ever pastored. You know, all have been good, I don't mean that. But you know, we get along good together. And that's good, you know. It's because you love the Lord and I love the Lord. We all love the Lord, and because we're looking. Remember that little poem I read this morning? Sort of goes along the last part of that poem. The Lord is coming back. I do remember services this evening, 5 o'clock. If you can't come a little early, we always have coffee, donuts, cookies, something to eat downstairs. We're Baptists, you know. And we always have fellowship downstairs. I thoroughly enjoyed that. We started that 3 or 4 years ago. And we've always had good turnouts, you know. We'll have a regular 5 o'clock service here in the sanctuary tonight. Since the program now is open, thank y'all, each one that had a part. You did a great job, you know. Also remember, Wednesday, if the kids will spread the word, be here at 5:30. Youth are going to have a program next Sunday morning, our young people. And you'll sort of spread, you know how you do that, spread the word, you know. They used to say telephone, telegraph, and tell a woman, so I don't know how. I'm getting no trouble with the ladies now. But y'all spread the word, and you got a child, grandchild, anybody, you look at program next Sunday morning, you have them here, if you would. And watch this now. They'll practice from 5:30 to 6:30, and then we'll all come upstairs, and all the kids will go downstairs. And I tell you what, you really might find a little pizza.
There's going to be a party down there.
You heard that, didn't you? That'll be food, yeah. Because these kids are Baptist kids. They know how to eat. And y'all have a pizza. Yeah, I'm getting it, baby.
I'm talking about chicken.
Yeah, watch that, man. I didn't have no foul mouth. But listen, yeah, I saw that. Listen, try to be here. Then you'll have your party at 6:30. Young people will have the rest upstairs. And listen, you know, I tell you, somebody loves me in church. You know what kind of gift I got today for Christmas? You'll never believe this. I got the prettiest black coffee mug. It's got the Three Stooges on it. Oh, Lord. So I guess they love it, you know. I've got a coffee mug with Three Stooges on it. Let's receive our morning tithes and offer so if our ushers will come at this time.